Hello everyone and welcome back to the Dutch Petting Zoo. And you may have already guessed it, but I'm joined again by Jurre.
Hallo.
Yes, yes. It has been a couple of months again, but we are back in the Petting Zoo. And today is kind of a finishing up episode. That's what I was planning. But I was looking around in this project and we called it a petting zoo. And then I thought, yeah, we added three animals, I think. We had the peafowl. We had some sheep. We had the warthogs. And
the cows, but that's not really a petting zoo one.
Right? Yeah, I've never pet. Oh, I did. Yeah, you can pet a cow.
Apparently they're nice to cuddle with or something.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. Yeah, but it's a bit weird to have in your living room.
Oh, that's actually anyway. Quite normal.
Oh, yeah.
Guess it's a cultural difference.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I was thinking, I was scrolling through the list of animals, and then I saw the llamas. And I was like, yeah, we can put some llamas in. So that's what I did today. And I did some finishing up, as you can see. Ooh. Right here. In real life, there was a big white building. I didn't make that because it didn't fit. I spent like 1.5 hours trying to get that in, but it didn't work. So in the end, I decided to put some bushes there.
That's the best thing.
Also nice.
Building something for an hour and then just, doesn't work.
Yeah.
Why?
No, I'm going to delete that.
Yeah.
So right now, I've seen some little tricks here and there when I did the competition showcase.
Oh.
So if you put these rocks and you sink them in, you get a really nice little effect here. So I'm copying that. And I was thinking, yeah, the piece count is not high enough in this zoo. So I'm going to add a trillion rocks. So that's what I'm doing. I did that all around the place. It looks really nice. You will see it in the cinematics. I didn't record it all because that would have been a very long and boring video. I also added some details to the walls because I thought the walls was a bit...
Wally.
Wally, yeah. So like only bricks and nothing on there. So I put something in there. You will see it in the cinematics because I forgot to record it. So it's a really short video, but I did do a lot. And a few surprises in the zoo. You have already seen it, but you will see it in the end.
Wait, have I?
You also, you've seen it.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
a friend of mine, Mr. Odicus, he made a fish stand store. And when I saw that, I was like, yeah, I can switch that to a fry shop stand.
Because you don't like fish. I don't like fish.
I don't like fish smells. And I think Jurre and I both love frikandellen and croquette.
Yep.
So I added that to the zoo.
Wait, I'm gonna go for a bit. I'm hungry now.
I'm gonna fry some frikandellen.
Yeah.
Which is nice. No, we will see that in the tour. We discussed this, so we will put it in the video. Jurre is gonna make a cinematic video.
Yes.
And we will do a Planet Zoo tour on this channel. Because this is going to be the final speed build. Oh, such a shame. We've been doing this for a year now, Jurre. And we made we made 10 episodes.
10 episodes.
So a really steady upload schedule of one video.
Hey, but when you look at it this way, like Netflix, like they drop everything in like a binge thing, right? But year after, season 2. But what we did is just spread it along across a year, so it's the same amount of content in a year.
Yeah, and probably the production value is like the same.
Maybe slightly less budget.
Exactly. So the llama habitat. So I'm making a little shelter.
I really like this shed there.
Yeah, it's really simple, but it's effective. I guess I didn't want to make like a beautiful building here because it's a petting zoo, and I think what you see in a petting zoo is like a little shed and what made out of wood,
mm-hmm.
which is falling apart, and that's it. So so I made this entire thing, then I dropped the llamas in, and it didn't fit, so the llamas couldn't leave the building. You will see a little jump in time where I changed everything, because the sides will be open because they didn't fit through the door. And
fit
this
llamas.
Part had to be, yeah, they were bigger than expected. I don't know.
That's what I hear a lot. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Yeah. We all know that's a joke. So.
It is.
Yeah. Some nice little details here. Also, do you remember the barrels that I made?
I do.
A couple of episodes ago.
I remember
that. Some decent ones.
I remember the Canon as well.
The Canon was really nice. I got some compliments about the Canons.
Oh, you did? So.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'm not sure if it was serious, yes or no, but I do like them.
I like the barrels.
I deleted them all because some good ones on the workshop.
Okay.
Which was also made by a Dutch guy and I forgot his name. Was it just Goron that is doing
the recreation of
the Beekse Bergen?
He's famous now. He's been in the news.
True. Yep. We also tried that. I contacted the people from Loevestein, which is this castle, and they said, really nice. Thank you. That was it. So that's all the support that we got with this project. But he became famous with it. Maybe because he was able to make barrels, and I.
I think that's it. That's the deciding factor. They saw those barrels you did, are like, oh no, we're not really interested.
Yeah, it's not worth it. the pathing here, that was fun. That took me literally an hour to get it in, to get the staircase in. I redid the entire thing. I was building this in the beginning, but I had to redo it. I tried some different pathing here with some temple stone pieces, but it didn't look right. But I wanted the guests to be able to come up here, so that's what we did. And I'm changing this a little bit for the staff to get in, and I will put some barrels there so it looks cool. So that will be staff area or people can buy a ticket to sit on a llama. I don't know if that's a thing.
I probably shouldn't, but,
but yeah some people can, some people don't.
Is that actually a thing, people do sit on a llama?
I don't know. Because I made something that you can sit on a llama, but you will see that with a really nice Dutch joke in there. But that will be in a few minutes, okay. I think. Oh, see, beautiful details here. I'm going for details. I got a comment lately from one of my friends in the Discord that said that my builds look cartoony. So I'm trying to make it more realistic. It really hurt my feelings. So I'm. I'm trying to make it better.
Every time I see your builds, I think I'm watching SpongeBob or something.
Yeah. Well, maybe I should do something like that. Like an underwater zoo. Yeah. Foliage, of course. I don't care about animal welfare. We didn't do anything about that. So everything looks Dutch and green and long grass and some bushes. Some nice things. Oh, yeah. I put also some green stuff on the floor here.
It's vomit.
Yeah. See? Ooh, beautiful. Beautiful.
Very nice, very nice.
And the grass was everywhere. I'm trying to put it.
You fixed this up nice, quite nicely actually. How it looks now.
See it in the end, like the part with the walls. I think it's a nice spot. It looks a bit more realistic with all the foliage. I don't like the long grass terrain work from the game. It's too. When you zoom out, you don't see it anymore.
Yeah, it's kind of
iffy. With the elephant grass looks better. Oh, there he is.
Oh, that's the barrel. A good barrel. How is that made?
Yeah, that's like 500 pieces.
Of course it is.
Yeah. Yep. And you can change the colors. I made it a little bit too red here, so I changed everything again. But I put some bins and then I cover it up with the barrels and I I remove them everywhere. So really nice barrels. I will put a link if I don't forget it in the. Down in the what do you call it? Description. Yes. Oh yeah, you saw the cannon right there. You saw
yes, the very nice
glimpse of it. And then I'm creating. This is gonna be a viewing area for the kids. So kids can't look over these fences. So I thought, I have to make something nice for them. I don't know. I keep making things for kids in this game. And see, it's a nice fence. Fixing it, and then there were some llama statues in the game, really ugly, but I thought it would be cool, so kids can sit on them and look at the llamas, and I will put a little sign up, says llama zitten. If you're Dutch, that's really funny, I think.
So stupid, dude.
I thought it was funny, but okay. You can sit on a llama right there and watch the animals. So really cool. And some bedding inside. Yeah, nice.
Very nice.
You have to eat. Foliage, terrain. All the good stuff I know you like. I mean, you were always complaining about this game, so... Do you want to complain about the game again this time?
The game? Oh, no. Nah, I've done that. I still haven't bought the aquatic pack. I still need to do that. So I might have to buy it to continue or to open up the park now or something. I don't know, actually. We'll see.
I'm not sure. See, I put another windmill in because I was really proud of the windmill. And I thought it needed something in the back here. So I'm doing all these fences. I think it's quite of a Dutch thing that you will have fences everywhere. I don't know. And
We're imprisoned. Yep.
Yeah. So some trees, and I actually put some cows in, which is cool.
Oh.
Yeah. So there are like cows walking everywhere now. No, but it's just like a little background for this habitat. So you have to hear the windmill again, which is recolorable. Very clever. I don't know who made that, but good call.
Very nice.
I'm extending your part here.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, another habitat. And I used your thing here. What's it called? The gate. Yeah, I copied it. So now when the grass is finished on one side, they can move to the other side.
Is that how it works? I'm not a farmer.
How it works. Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, I'm not either. I just say it works like that.
Okay. But he doesn't really, or he's joking.
No, it's really. Sometimes, the place where I used to live, we had like cows crossing the street because they were moving.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so that actually happens. If you don't agree with me, let me know.
let me call my lawyer, he will know.
yeah, exactly. So I put some more cows in here, and that was almost it. I did a lot of finishing up, and you will see that in.
Is there staff building inside there?
Yeah, there was a little staff building in there.
All right.
I thought it would need a keeper how to feed these animals. So I put that one in. So, that was it.
Nice.
You have the cinematics.
Ooh.
Beautiful. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. It was the final speed build. Sad moment. We will do some tours. And we will see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.
Bye.
You.